Well, while I got this thing torn almost all the way apart, I'm gonna go ahead and change these steering bushings. That is a lot of, kind of hard to see on video, but really wish I could have got some aftermarket ones that are a little firmer and actually have a special bushing in there. But stock ones will last me another long time. So here goes. There's the upper two done. New one there, new one there. And already there's just about no play there. I still have one more to do down here. So that one coming up next, but even just replacing these upper two made a huge difference. I'm gonna put some white lithium grease in there just for extra measure. But yeah, this is the difference here. I mean, that's the old one. Doesn't look terribly deformed, but compared to the new one, there is definitely a little bit of difference there. It's really hard to line up and see, but very close, but these are definitely pretty beat out. The old ones here, you can tell that they were, yeah, pretty much shot. Anyway, up next, we'll replace that one. And then we're probably gonna go right on to running the new cable, throttle cable, because this one definitely has some burrs in it. I was running into issues last winter of it, the cable not wanting to retract into the sleeve. So I'm sure between kinked, messed up places like that and other areas down further, this one has issues. So I'm gonna take this one off. I'll keep it for a spare in case I get in a pickle. But new throttle cable and the finger throttle going on. So first up, last steering bushing, and then we'll move on from there. That was really easy, and man, is there ever a difference. Like, this is nice and tight, no flopping whatsoever. So yeah, that's exciting. No slop whatsoever. So that'll get me through another couple good seasons. Anyway, on to the next thing, new throttle cable. Coming up. Well, all I can say is this throttle cable is a job and a half. I tried everything in my power to get that end of the cable hooked back up without having to pull the whole air box out, disconnect the coils, the sensor here, everything. I tried and that shortcut did not work out. All it did was frustrate the living hell out of me. So finally pulled the air box out and managed to get in here properly to hook up that end of the cable. So that's done. All I can say is should have done it from the start and maybe I wouldn't be so mad right now. But anyway, it's hooked on. Now I just gotta root it up through to the handlebars the way I want and then put this whole mess back in there. Anyway, don't take shortcuts. The only way to get the end of that cable, throttle cable hooked up properly in there is by taking the air box out. I tried fiddling around blind in there for way, way too long and it does not work. Does not work. So, time to start putting this all back together. The throttle cable's back in, rooted up to the new finger throttle. So things are looking up there. I just gotta put the kill switch in and then zip tie these wires where I want them. Make them all nice and tidy down into here. Little Velcro pocket here. And then it's just about time to start putting everything back together. You'll notice the bumper's missing off the front here. Same with the back. That is because they are away getting powder coated. So as soon as those are done, they'll come back on. Obviously got to throw this secondary clutch back on. Had to take that off when I was being a stubborn idiot trying to change the throttle cable. But anyway, down to the nitty gritty. Not too shabby. Side note, I put dielectric grease on every electrical connection after I take it apart. I had to unplug the ECU earlier. Those connections, dielectric grease. The heater cord up to my new finger throttle, dielectric grease. For me, it's a no-brainer. Big help. Keeps moisture out of those connections, and we all know moisture is the death of good electronics, so dielectric grease on every electrical connection. That is it. All I gotta do is put the bumpers on when they come back from powder coating and fill this puppy up with coolant and she will be ready to rock. Good to go. Obviously, I will also have to go through the setup of the suspension. With it being all new, I will have to go through that one of these days, set up my preloads and hop off and on it with all my gear on, see how much it sags, all that good stuff. So save that for a later video. But it's just about done. This is exciting.